Hey crafters, thank you for joining me today. I'm back to show you some Christmas projects that I have been working on recently, and I wanted to post a video today that is not card related because I know I've been posting a lot of card projects lately and I really have fun creating cards, but I wanted to do a different type of paper crafting and something that is also a home decor, or you can create something like this as a Christmas gift. This is also a great idea if you're thinking about giving a Christmas gift to someone who has everything, or to a teacher or your workmates and things like that, then this is one of the things that you can make and I know that they will appreciate. So this is a waterless snow globe, and I posted a sample of this last Halloween and showed you also how to put together the house die, the little houses that I use for the snow globe. So I'm not going to show you how to put together the house anymore, and I will just link that video down below so you guys can see how the houses were put together. So I wanted to show you guys these two projects that I finished already. This is pretty inexpensive, of course, so you don't have to spend a lot of money to create one of these. And if you don't have the house die, then you can probably just get some of those little crafty things that you can find at Michael's in a pack. Like this is an example of the Christmas trees that I used, and some other craft supplies that you can find. I mean, this is the reindeer that I use. This is actually just buttons, and I just cut off the back and just used the reindeer, and it turned out really cute. So you just need to use your imagination. But let me show you the first one. And again, this is using an empty candle jar that I'm just repurposing. And instead of buying those snow globes from Michael's or other craft store, you can just reuse an empty candle jar like these, because the snow globes is like $7 or something, so it's pretty expensive to begin with. So if you are a candle lover like me and you have a ton of these, then use your empty glass jar. So this is how it looks like. And the tree, I got that from Hobby Lobby, which is this brand. And the ribbon I also got from Hobby Lobby, and it just came in one pack like so. And I just trimmed the tree there, and the house die I already showed you, and I'm going to link that video down below on how to put together the house die. But I decided to leave the windows and the doors just plain like that instead of covering them up with paper, because I wanted the light to shine through. Because I think I'm going to use some fairy lights here, some battery operated LED lights. So that's why I decided to leave the windows and the door alone. I just put my fake snow there. I have this huge bag that I have in my stash, and I just put the fake snow there. And then if you're wondering what these are, it came in a pack and I got it from Michael's. And these are just some plastic light bulbs or something that I use to make them look like Christmas lights. And the reindeer there I got, or deer, I got from Art Attack Supplies, and it's a pack of 7 for like $1.99 or something. So, but you can find those also at a local craft store like Michael's or Hobby Lobby. So I just used my liquid applique to create the snow there. And I decided to trim the tree with the red bow. I was going to use initially this light bulb string that I got from Hobby Lobby, but I decided that I preferred that look. And I just put that snow. And if you're wondering what this little fence is right here, it's just one of my magnolia doohickey die that I cut, and I just worked it with my fingers and just did this just a little bit, and then I hot glued it inside to make it look like there's a fence there. So that's the first one, and then I just used my silver rickrack to just finish it off, just to give it a better look. And the second one is just a white Christmas theme, and I didn't have white pine trees or bottle brush trees is what you're calling this. So I didn't have some white ones, and I'm gonna ask my daughter to bring me some. So I decided to use my diamond dies Christmas tree die and just cut out six and adhered at the back. You can see that it's also glittery. I adhered two glitter paper back to back, so the back also looks finished. And I decided to make this just white and gold because the lid of my candle jar is gold. So I decided I'll make this like a white Christmas theme. And I just used my stars to just give the house a little bit of color because it's all white. And I use my icicles dye that I got from Magnolia this year. But you can also use liquid applique to create snow there. And the fake snow, of course. With the light bulbs there, I just hot glued everything at the bottom. And since this is white and gold, I decided to use the gold color light bulb. And then that reindeer is just one of the buttons that I showed you earlier, and I thought it turned out really cute. So you can create something like this using your empty candle glass jars, and it's pretty inexpensive. You can buy those little houses from a craft store, I guess, if you don't have the house die. And you can create something like this. It's a great gift for a coworker or a boss or a teacher. And this is just a nice decoration. So I made quite a bit because I'm going to bring one to my mother and my siblings. I'm going to see them next week. I'm actually traveling next week. So I decided to make a bunch of these and give it also as Christmas presents. So if you would like to see how this is made, then please keep watching. So the final touch is to just add the rickrack here to finish off this candle jar. Maybe I will add this glass candlestick at the bottom of these, and this will be a perfect gift. So as you can see, this is a very easy project to create, and in fact your kids will have fun creating some of these with you. Make some waterless snow globes with you, and I'm sure the kids will have so much fun creating these with you. Create some great memories this Christmas season. That is it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you have any questions, please send me a message. And if you like this project, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, please. I really do appreciate it. And I'll see you on my next crafting project. Bye for now, and have an amazing day.